Bienvenidos a Estrategias de Inversión. A continuación vamos a buscar oportunidades de inversión en España y también en emergentes, centrándonos en Latinoamérica. Y para ello vamos a hablar con Patrice Dussol, director de ventas para Iberia y Latam de Odo Asset Management. Patrice, bienvenido. ¿Qué tal?
Gracias, Rocío. Gracias de acogerme hoy.
Comencemos por la bolsa española, porque sí, hemos visto a nuestro mercado subir holgadamente este 2013. Sin embargo, de cara a 2014, que ya estamos acabando este año, ¿tendremos que ser más selectivos, más stock pickings?
Yes, clearly. By Odo, we don't have any macroeconomic approach. Okay, we will look really at the stocks and the valuation. That's the key point of the management. So, yes, true that last year, like the many European markets, the Spanish exchange has risen significantly. Mm-hmm. But we think that if you do a CV and a rigorous stock selection, you can still find value for the coming months and for 2014. That is to say that if you can find very good quality stocks with a strong upside, a strong potential for the stocks, because you have in Europe a lot of companies which have a strong part of their business made outside the Eurozone, mm-hmm. So they are less dependent, they are more independent from the Eurozone than the rest of the domestic values, by example. And I could say that like companies like coming the healthcare sector or industrials have a strong potential because most of their business is made outside the Eurozone and they have a global reach, which allow them to have a continuous growth in their turnover and also of their profits.
Y una de las posiciones que tienen en su fondo Avenir Europe es a Amadeus, está entre sus principales posiciones. No sé si responde precisamente a esa política de inversión en búsqueda de valor que comentas.
Yes, that's true. Amadeus, you know, is the global central observation in Europe, and they have like an institution of their like in a monopoly, mm-hmm. for the booking and reservations. So we think this stock is very interesting because they have the criteria of selection fits to our that the company is fixed to our criteria of selection. Firstly, we have a free cash flow, which is important. Companies is very profitable, and Amadeus has a presence worldwide. And for that, we think that there is a strong potential for the stock for the coming months.
Eso en cuanto a la selección para la renta variable, pero para la renta fija vemos, por ejemplo, en el fondo Odo Convertibles que tienen sobre todo exposición a bonos de BBB. ¿Por qué estas posiciones donde ven más valor ahora mismo la renta fija?
Sí, bueno, en el mundo de las de convertibles, en nuestros in our portfolios, we have a lot of bonds with a rating of BBB. That is to say that we found value in this part of the in this part of the bonds. When we look at the convertibles, we look at the convexity. Mm-hmm. So that means that after 4 years of maturation, even if the equity markets are going down, the convertible can have a positive return. That's what we look in our portfolio. So. And if you look at the universe, in the triple B, let's say, universe, you can find very good stocks, which have a good correlation with the equity, because of course the correlation between equities and the convertible is very strong. And so not to be, if you are investment grade with triple B, you can find after 4 or 5 years a very good yield. And protection in terms of quality of bond picking.
Y vamos a cambiar de tercio, vamos a irnos a Latinoamérica porque, bueno, vemos este año, estos meses, los mercados latinoamericanos muy perjudicados por la política económica que está llevando, la política monetaria que está llevando a cabo Estados Unidos. No obstante, las perspectivas económicas en esa región siguen siendo crecientes, destacaría algunos países incluso.
Yes, so we have strong hopes and prospects in South America, especially in three countries, which are Chile, Peru, and Colombia. But first, these countries have a positive growth, steady. They are benefiting from their natural resources. For example, with the RAM in Chile. What is more, the financial system in those countries is very solid. So it's they are very professional in their approach. I can talk the example of the IFPs, you know, the pension funds over there, which are very regulated. So now, as the population is young, they collect a lot of money for the pensions, and of course the balance is positive. There is more money to come than spent for the pensioners, especially in Colombia, where with 35 million people, they think there will be an upturn in 2025. So during more than 15 years, they can still collect money for the pensions. So it's a growth of 2 digits every year. So of course they want to diversify their investments to be less dependent from the equity and the bonds of the home country. Mm. So they are more open-minded to look at value in emerging markets and also in the United States and Europe. So there is a clear rally for many managers in this region to raise assets. And we think that if you have one or two good strategies with a good track record, you can raise money and penetrate those markets. So even if you look at Chile, clearly in this moment there is an election for the new president. Mr. Piñera is leaving, and now it's an election between two men. The former prime minister was Michelle Bachelet, mm-hmm. and she has 47% vote in the first round, so she will be clearly re-elected. But even if she's from the left wing, it won't change too much the policy. It will be more social policy, but I mean the fundamentals of the country will carry on, and that's the reason why we have a strong hopes and we want to go in Chile and in this region.
¿Nos recomendaría algún sector en concreto para invertir y beneficiarnos de este crecimiento, de estas perspectivas económicas en Latinoamérica?
As we have the middle class generation, which is rising and getting maybe more purchase power, clearly the construction and the raw materials are, according to me, maybe the banking sector will be also the sectors which you have to look for very closely for the coming months.
Mm-hmm. Claro, los sectores de más crecimiento, ¿no? Beneficiándose de ese poder adquisitivo y de la población joven, todo lo contrario de lo que nos pasa aquí. Pues nos apuntamos esas recomendaciones de inversión. Patrice Dussol, director de ventas para Iberia y Latam de Audaces Management. Muchísimas gracias y hasta la próxima.
Bueno, fue un placer, gracias.
Y ustedes recuerden que pueden seguir informados de la actualidad económica en nuestra web, estrategiasdeinversión.com.